In this video, we will set up the MySQL installation in Windows WSL and access it through the host machine. After logging in into the WSL, we update or upgrade all existing packages just to be sure that all packages are at their latest stable version. Once the system-wide update is done, we install our MySQL server on the WSL. To check if the MySQL server is successfully installed, we run this command to output installed version. Now using this command, we start the installed MySQL server. These commands may be different for other distros of Linux, you may consult the web accordingly. By making use of sudo command, we can log in as root user into the MySQL server and set the root user password to some value. In this case, we are setting the root user password as my password. Now, we run this command to initialize other parameters of our MySQL database server. We need to enter the MySQL root password here, which we just set as my password. Other choices can be same or changed according to your use case. We can test whether our credentials are working fine or not by using this command and enter the MySQL root password. Here, we are writing query to show the databases present in our MySQL server. Now we are changing the default port on which this MySQL server would be running to a non-default port. This action would allow us to run two different MySQL servers simultaneously, one on WSL and one on the host machine itself. We are choosing port 33061 for this MySQL server. Now at the end, let's restart the server and set the service to be auto-loaded on startup using these commands. Now we are all set. Let's use our host machine to connect to this MySQL server. We are using Heidi SQL client to connect, you can use any one of your liking. Now we are logged in, and able to access the databases. The good thing about this approach is we do not need to worry about the IP addresses of the WSL machine, we can use the local host address just with different port. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe if you can.